guys. I hope that you are looking forward to this season of...
Check it out. Just sing to the line. Make you feel good. Make you feel all right. One time. Feel good, yeah, y'all. Bust the pounds in the place, y'all. Nigga, you feel real good, y'all. Flip Moses squad in the place.
And now, presented by Sprite, the 2K pregame show.
Hello again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal on 2K Sports, and the NBA season is about to begin. Tonight, we'll see the Miami Heat playing against the Cleveland Cavaliers. And looking at the Cavaliers, they were swept by this team last season, losing all three games they played against them. So they'll be motivated tonight. Well, everybody's talking about the Cleveland Cavaliers. Why don't we get in on the fun? Cleveland Cavaliers have LeBron James back. Is this team potentially, I hate to use the word dynasty, in the making, Shaq?
Ernie, we will see. You know, LeBron is still fairly young. He will be in his prime for several years still. He has a lot of high picks to go around him. We all know how he plays. So unselfish, he's going to make those guys better. But using the word dynasty, I don't know about that one yet.
What an intriguing story to follow here in 2014. Hey, let's go to Kevin Harlan and the rest of the 2K Sports crew.
See the Miami Heat defending home turf in the Eastern Conference.
This is Kevin Durant. Welcome to 2K.
And it's the Cavaliers to start out. A look at Cleveland's starting group. Irving and Waiters, the guards. The two stars, LeBron and Love, at the three and the four. And it's Varejao in at the center position. And that's out of bounds. Cleveland will retain possession.
The Cavs just never really built any consistency last year for long stretches. And, you know, when that happens, it's hard to get wins away from home.
Now here's LeBron, shot clock at six. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Well, it's funny, back when LeBron joined the Heat, some critics said he'd given up the chance to be the franchise player and carry his team. But guess what? No matter who LeBron plays with, he's always the franchise player. That's how good he is.
And you think back to LeBron after the 2011 finals, many also questioned whether he had, you know, quote unquote, what it took to win a title. He's obviously answered those questions.
Free throws good from James. And some harsh criticism, Clark, for LeBron after the decision or his comments after the 2011 finals.
Yeah, you know what, Kevin? It's really impressive to see how he's handled that. He know he misspoke and mishandled both of those situations. And to his credit, he's expressed regret about those things. But displaying a maturity we've always seen in him. One of the remarkable things about LeBron is that for the magnitude of his celebrity and his stature and the expectations, I don't know if we've had an athlete handle himself any better under the hot, bright lights of stardom.
Enzo Chalmers nails both of them.
Well, Mario Chalmers coming into last season made a bet with Ray Allen about how much each could slim down and get in peak shape. Seemed to pay dividends for Chalmers in particular, who had probably the best season of his NBA career.
It is so hard to contain him. He just seems to get it done however he has to do it.
Wade against Waiters. Outside Dang. Back to Wade. The shot will not go. Good D by LeBron.
And Chalmers really not the quickest point guard in the league, but he has active hands defensively and pretty good feet. And those takeaways help get the Heat out in the open court, which certainly plays to their strengths.
Now Irving, after Deion Waiters' three-pointer that didn't go. Irving drives in. Missed it, even after all those chances. Here is Mick Roberts. He's guarded by Love. Here's Wade. And so just over a minute and a half played. No one near James as he lets it go. Cans it from downtown. LeBron's got 7 points in the game. And Chalmers, more of a role player for the Heat. Not a huge playmaker, Steve, but he can knock down open threes.
Yeah, he's an efficient scorer. And his passing has gotten better over the last couple of seasons. He's a perfect role player for Miami because he can guard opposing point guards extremely well and then slide off the ball when Wade has it.
Pass to Wade. Chalmers with a screen for Wade. Right at the free throw line, and he gets it to go. Wade's got his first points of the night.
He's definitely got that shot in his arsenal.
LeBron passes to Irving. And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Wade against Waiters. Solid play in the low block, and that one's good.
The defense left him just a little window to get through, and he just ducked in for the layup. Terrific job.
The drive by Wade, and he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. You can list off a lot of accolades for Dwayne Wade, but one thing that might get overlooked is just how good he is at throwing the alley-oop pass.
Absolutely. It shouldn't be a surprise since he's so skilled at so many other facets of the game, but he might go down as one of the better alley-oop throwers of all time. Andre Miller's in that category,
yes,
too.
Yes, two very, very good examples. That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
With Wade, you look at a lot of the year-end highlights for any season in the past few years, and a lot of them are just him throwing down those majestic-looking alley-oops.
Irving's shot is good.
Boy, that was impressive. Major height disadvantage, but he still got the shot up over his man.
Well, he's got the poise to handle any matchup, and he's not easily intimidated. You can see that there.
Wade drives in, takes it into the teeth of the D, and converts the layup. Wade's got 6.
And one final thing about Wade's alley-oop passes. He can throw them accurately from almost anywhere. I recall one he threw from almost half, well, almost the foul line at the other
end.
To LeBron James in a game against the Pacers. As soon as he gets it, even near his own half-court line, he's a threat that kept somebody sleeping.
The Heat trail by 3. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Kevin, thank you. The conversation veered to the challenge of defending LeBron James, and he said there's not a lot of good options with him. He can really do it all. I think you just have to try and stay in front of him, and if he gets in close, you have to bring help. And guys, we've seen LeBron really force the issue as far as getting into the lane. We'll see how they do.
Thanks a lot, Doris. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
D-Wade draws a ton of attention for his explosive offensive talent. But people tend to forget what an impact player he is in other facets of the game as well. I mean, he gives you rebounds, assists, steals, block shots. I think it's his all-around game that has him assured of being a first-ballot Hall of Famer.
And Wade, with long arms, athleticism, great timing, one of the all-time great shot blockers among guards. In fact, for his career, averaging about a block a game to go with two steals as well. So a terrific nose for the ball.
Here's what Miami's going with right now. Chris Anderson has checked in for Bosch. Haslam comes in for Josh McRoberts. Danny Granger has checked in for Lou Aldang. And Cole subbed in for Mario Chalmers. Stolen by Wade. Oh, and a fast break for the Heat. A finish. Oh, and a jam by Granger.
That was a quick bucket. Pretty good in transition.
That's right. That's exactly right. He loves when he gets the chance to get out and run. That's when he's at his best.
And Wade, a very good one-on-one defender, but the Heat had the luxury of often putting him off the top scorers on the other side.
Yeah, and with Lou Aldang, who can guard the point of attack, now Wade almost can operate like a free safety, using his speed to pick off passes or stuff a driver at the rim. Well, I think the defense got lucky right there. I mean, he's going to make a lot more of those than he misses when he's got that much room.
And out of bounds as the Heat gain possession.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. Terrible turnover.
Napier, who's checked in for Miami. Miami trailing. 58 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Granger outside. Kicks to Anderson. No good. Good D from Love. Cavaliers have gone 6 of 9, shooting it well. Feeds it to Marion. The tray. Another three for Cleveland.
Dellavedova is really good at finding his teammates.
And so here is Miami. And Cole kicks to Granger. Ball's knocked loose, and it's out of bounds to the Heat as Miami retains possession. Seconds left here in the opening quarter. Here's Napier, and two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. That one on Love. Miami shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight.
Yeah, very average shooting team in terms of the free throw line. About 76% a year ago.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Varejao's checked in. And good on the second, so he makes them both.
You know, he's as close to a sure thing as you can possibly have when he steps to the line.
Here's Dellavedova. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. It's Marion with the drive, and the foul called on Sean Marion. That's his first foul.
What a great play to sacrifice his body and take the hit.
Yeah, I thought that was excellent awareness and anticipation to beat him to the spot there.
Here's Cole. Passes it to Granger. Out to the wing. Cole's shot is good. Cole's got his first points in this one.
Everybody on the floor is hot. Incredible stuff here in the early stages.
Tell you what, both teams playing downhill. Who's going to blink first?
Tie game and some big points being put up on the board, Clark, as we wrap up the first. And don't go away. We'll be back at the action for the start of the second quarter in just a moment. Second quarter getting